Good evening, traders. Welcome to 200forexwhips.com. I am here with a technical analysis of 7th of September 2020. So, guys, first of all, if you have any kind of inquiry, then please do contact on info@200forexwhips.com. Also, guys, the link of my WhatsApp group is in the description of this video below. So, make sure that you also join the WhatsApp group and also subscribe to the YouTube channel. Okay, guys, now we will talk about the technical analysis for today. I personally use this trend dashboard platform for my own analysis. So it is very helpful tool. So you can also use it for your personal trading. So, guys, let's get started from Euro USD. So, guys, if you look at Euro USD, it has changed its pattern. It's look from 1 minute to even up to daily chart. It's showing us maximum down signs. And if you look at the complete pattern, then you can see that Euro USD is moving into the downward direction. But however, if you look at the higher time frames like the weekly chart, then it is indicating you that that it's into the upward direction. So, guys, look, if you are a scalper, then you can take a sell positions. But later on, when you see that a significant drop has occurred into the market, then you can buy the pair. And this is how you can use this trend dashboard indicator. Guys, please note that this is a very useful tool, and all experienced and even new buy traders should have this tool with them, because this is very good for trading and it can make your trading very simpler. I am going to talk about Great Britain Pound USD now. Now look at here, maximum signals are down from the trend dashboard indicator, and if we make the trend line here, then you can completely see the market is dropping on Great Britain Pound USD, which was a clear signal, whereas on the weekly signs we have the upper direction. So buying it at the lower price can be a good option for a weekly swing trade. At next we have AUD USD. So overall, guys, if I put the line here on AUD USD, then you can see that it's just ranging into the markets overall. But if you consult the indicator, it is telling you the downward direction. So I suggest you not to trade AUD USD right now until unless it does not change its behavior, because it's ranging from many days, and so we have to wait for the rhythm of the market, and once the rhythm gets settled, then you can execute any trades. Okay, now let's talk about USD Canadian dollar. So let me clear my chart, guys. Sorry, the chart wasn't clear. Okay, now it's fine. Okay, guys, now look at here. So kind of a mixture of a bullish and bearish. So how to follow this one? So guys, look on the here. On the 1 hour, we have maximum up signs. So if you are, for example, going to take a trade on 1 hour, then look at this. What's going on? It's making the bullish pattern right from here. So scalping chances can be on. You can buy USD Canadian dollar for some time based on the trend dashboard indicator. And we have two down signs on the 1 hour chart. They can be eliminated soon if the market goes into the upward direction. So guys, overall, a bullish expectation is seen, whereas on the longer time frames, please do not forget that it is indicating us the downward direction. At next we have USD CHF. If you look at USD CHF, then guys, if you look at here, the up to the 4 hour chart, the market was up, and on even on the daily's chart we have only two down signs, but rest of the signs were up. And if you look at the momentum here, then the market has moved into the upward direction, so which means that the trend and the indicator was telling us the right path, that the market can go up, and the market has finally went up. Okay, USD JPY. So guys, look at the chart here. Maximum upward directions are given by the trend indicator, and if you make the small trend line here based on today, then you can see the market has made the upward move today. So overall, but do not forget, on the weekly time frame we have the down signs. So if it comes into the top levels, then you can take the sell position. So this is how you can use this one. Okay, Great Britain Pound JPY. So look at here, overall maximum down signals are coming by the trend dashboard indicator, and you can see, and overall it is still indicating that the market is into the weaker sides. Look at the daily down, and everything is down. So until unless it does not change its behavior, if you even make the trend line here, then you can see the market is getting the drops. Overall selling opportunities are on Great Britain Pound JPY. Now let's talk about gold. So guys, look at here. I have also highlighted you in my previous videos that for the short term basis, if we talk about gold, then it's sell. Now I'm preparing the trend line here, then you can see that my prediction was pretty right on gold, that on the shorter time frames it is completely into the downward direction. But do not forget that still we have weekly up direction here, so gold can go up anytime. It can go up anytime. So guys, nothing is sure about gold, that when it can go anytime up. So just wait for the one long bullish candle, then you will be into the touch that the market is going to break its behavior and it's going into another way. So I think so market movers are planning something big on this one, because it is they are assuming that people, most of the people must be assuming that gold is going down, that I have also highlighted in my previous video. But do not forget that the main trend is still up, so be careful with gold. Scalp, if you want to scalp, then sell. Okay, but if you want to plan a long trade, then guys, let it come down more so that you can have a better price to buy this pair. At next we have AUD JPY. So guys, kind of a mixture of up and down signals, but however on the daily we have the up signs. But overall, if you look at the market, this is the market that I do not personally trade, because the market is ranging here, so no good signs of the signal here. So overall you cannot trade a chart which is completely flat. At next we have Euro JPY. So it was easy to trade. Look at here, maximum down signals were appeared by the trend dashboard indicator, and going towards it, you can see it's completely down. So I am also using it for my own technical analysis and for my personal trades as well. So guys, you should also use this one. That is why I'm emphasizing this thing again and again, that it's a must tool that our traders should have. Now look at New Zealand USD. Down signals were predicted from the trend by dashboard indicator, and look at New Zealand USD, it completely went down as per the prediction that is highlighted by the trend dashboard indicator. So guys, this is a very good indicator, so it's a kind of a must tool that a trader should have. So guys, if you want to get the copy of this trend dashboard indicator, then please do contact me instantly on info@200forexpips.com. if you want to get the red boundary indicator that we use in our earlier videos, you know that we are also using the red boundary indicator as well. So if you want to use the copy of the red boundary indicator scalper and the price action monitor, and if you want to get the expert advisor, and guys, most importantly, if you are willing to book your forex trading coaching session with me on Skype, this will be a one-to-one live session, and I take personal coaching sessions every week. So if you want to book your coaching session with me, then for all this, please contact immediately on info@200forexpips.com. Thank you for watching the video, guys. Please like my video, subscribe my YouTube channel, and share this technical analysis with everyone. Have a good day. Bye.